This is Wade, a hard-working man from Baltimore, Maryland, with an unusually large gift. The gift of filling your mouth with some mammoth meat. A sweet treat slipped between two buns. Well, I'm getting ahead of myself. As a child, Wade was always captivated by collecting things, such as sports memorabilia, stray dogs, and pigeons. Many of the same things that every 10-year-old boy finds himself collecting. Though at one point, Wade's collecting brought himself to the dark side, jarring cockroaches and freezing them for fun. Soon to outgrow this hoodlum immature shenanigans, Wade, unlike many others, found salvation through the art of manhandling meat. Wade took all his passion for collecting, matched with pure aggravation and rage, and constructed his very first meat shack at age 17. Even though it was more like a glorified lemonade stand, in my opinion. Shut down almost immediately for serving severely undercooked dog meat burgers, Wade found himself out of work, rent to pay, and in a tough situation with nowhere to turn. Wade was forced to reach out to longtime friend, Ernie Big Boss Jones.
Yeah, I'm saying, hey, Wade, if you need some help, man, we should start like a barbecue joint, man. You sell some burgers and stuff, and it'd be nothing like it. Barbecue, that might be pretty top-notch, but we'll see what happens. Let's start it.
3 years of manual labor later, Ernie and Wade found themselves in business together, making a legitimate name for their establishment, conveniently called Smoked Out Barbecue and Burgers. Things quickly turned sour between the what were once close friends. Just as fast as the business got off the ground, it came burning down. Ernie quickly became jealous of how popular Wade's burgers had gotten, and where there was lack of sales in barbecue, there was an increase in deceit. Just like that, Ernie purchased a gas tank, drove to the store, dropped the match, and drove away. Was gone before the fire was calmed. This leaving Wade close to broke again, and to salvage what he could from the ashes. One of the customers that had been frequently dining in the establishment was so upset and disgusted by the act of Wade's former partner that he decided to donate a major portion of what was needed for the rebuild. Wade's Burgers were born, home of the Mammoth Mammy Burger. Forget the Burger Queens and Mickey D's or Wendy's taking on Five Guys. Wade's Mammoth Mammy Burger was 4 times the size and half the price. So much meat it'll knock you off your seat. Whoa! Listen to these testimonies.
Yeah, man, like, what I like to do is I like to get stoned and come into Wade's Burgers, man, and it's really good.
I mean, if I only had one thing to eat and I was stranded on a desert island, I definitely want like a bag full of Wade. Like, oh my god, just this meat. Yeah, I can't get enough of it.
Wade's boop can best, bruh. Boop. Best, bruh. I mean, boop. It's the best.
Now with everything in place, Wade will be able to live out his dreams and live happily ever after. Wait, whatever happened to Ernie? And why are there so many missing people in surrounding areas around Baltimore? And who was this mystery customer who decided to dump a lump sum into a strange bank account? Was there more than meets the eye behind the store fire? I guess you'll have to wait for the second installment of Wade's Behind the Burger. Do 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 do